kind of like cloud was a couple years ago, where people are like, oh yeah, I know what that is. And now we're here 3 years later and like, I know exactly how to explain cloud. Well, that's where SDN is today. A lot of people use a controller with dumb APs. So they're APs that are not autonomous. That is a very, very visual definition of what is potentially possible in SDN. It is a separate control plane that is on a device that controls multiple devices throughout the network. Most people are doing it, and they've been doing that for several years. So applying that same kind of concept, but to the entire network. So the network switching, network routing, as well as wireless, all centrally controlled. So extracting that control plane. What that gives you is several things. If you have specific applications, you can write the applications so they speak directly to those devices. So there's no need to program the devices in advance. The application speaks to that device and says, hey, I need this kind of service level. The device will take that information and talk to the rest of the network and say, hey, we've got this new application, it's on the network, here's what it needs. Let's make sure that it gets the service that it deserves. So Cisco's 1PK, or their open network environment, has a lot of feature functionalities. That specifically addresses the market space where you build an application to specifically talk to the network devices. And that's kind of the first approach to SDN. The second is that controller based. And the third is a kind of a combination where you're also using an overlay. So virtual devices, a virtual network overlaid a physical network. The Nexus 1000V has its own context. Those are virtual devices that can operate on a physical device. I'll use the example of QoS because it's pretty easy to pick on. Nowadays, we pre-configure a network to support voice or video. In the future, when you look at a software-defined networking, that device you plug in or the phone has its application, and people are used to downloading an app. So that app talks to the immediate device and says, hey, this is what I need, this is how I need to operate on your network. And then the network goes and does that configuration dynamically. So you're not really having to pre-program and guess that, hey, maybe I might have X number of calls or I might have X number of video conversations. It's a different approach where the network says, okay, I see you coming, let's make sure that you have the right capabilities and I'll do the programming automatically.